Hey guys, Zane from the Infinite Jukebox here with another album review, and today I wanted to talk about the new MS Paint record, Post-American. MS Paint is a band that, thanks to an incredibly dedicated underground cult following, have been hyped up for a few years now at this point, and they've paid some of their dues by opening up for well-loved modern-day punk bands like Soulglow and Gel, meaning that they are finally ready to shine on their own. The four-piece are incredibly unique, and their debut studio album, Post-American, demonstrates that perfectly. Rather than just directly lifting sounds or styles from classic hardcore or proto-hardcore bands like, say, Bad Brains or Negative Approach, MS Paint do something entirely unique and make the subgenre all their own. The first thing that the listener may notice is the complete lack of guitar work found here, which was a shock for myself and surely many others when first approaching this band. The band has the makings of a regular four-piece punk-slash-rock band at first, with vocalist Dee Dee, bassist Randy, and drummer Quinn. However, it is when synthesizer player Nick steps in that things begin to get pretty interesting, a little spicy, if you will, as we see him take the place of a traditional guitarist. Vicious synth work replacing your average guitar may be off-putting to some, understandably, but there's no denying that Nick has more bite and more energy in his synth playing than most electric guitar players have in their entire career of performance work. On the other hand, the synthesizers also add a nice atmosphere, surprisingly, to the entirety of Post-American, and atmosphere is something that can be difficult to come by on your average punk album. And although that isn't something necessary for most punk or hardcore records, it is really nice to hear on an album like this that manages to pull it off with great success. In fact, this record has an incredibly unique tone overall, largely thanks to that aforementioned atmosphere that is created throughout the entirety of this record. It almost feels like it's some sort of strange, mangled, meshed-up kind of form of hardcore from an alternate sci-fi dimension. It just feels wildly neo-futuristic, yet at the same time very much rooted in the modern day of punk. It's a difficult record to describe, and members of the band have chosen not to be labeled as just punk or synth punk or anything like that. As they have stated themselves, they were just people in a rock band that formed another band together with all of their own influences, doing their own unique thing, and that's exactly what it sounds like. It's possible to trace MS Paint back to a number of different influences, but the way that they sound so not quite of this time, or not quite of this timeline maybe, that they really do stand out. I digress, there is that futuristic tone, but of course the record itself is still heavily rooted in the best and most bold moments of hardcore punk. Meanwhile, the brief 30-minute runtime only adds to the rapid-fire punch sort of vibe of the record as a whole. This album just genuinely feels like you're getting hit with a bag of bricks repeatedly for about 30 minutes, and I do mean that in the best way possible, as there have been a lot of great punk albums to come out over the past few months, but none have felt quite as energetic or relentless as Post-American. It's always nice to see a very hyped-up band release a debut studio album, or any studio album for that matter, that manages to accurately represent their best qualities as a project. Albums like MS Paint's Post-American are even more impressive when you take into account that this record has potential to be a contender as the single most consistent and striking rock-slash-punk album of the year thus far. I'm going to give this record 4 stars out of 5. And with that being said, that's the end of this quick album review. I've been Zane from the Infinite Jukebox. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.